So folks, we're here to share about Jesus today, to share the Word of God. To share,
aye bro, God bless you. You too, God bless you.
To share the Word of God, the pure Word of God. It says in the Word of God, all Scripture is given by inspiration of God and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, and for salvation. The Word of God is a lamp to our feet, and the Word of God can help you know how to get to heaven. So we're going to get the Word of God. And in the Word of God, it says, Paul, and Silvanus, and Timothy, unto the church of the Thessalonians, which is in God the Father. The question is, are you in God the Father today? Do you know God the Father? That there is God the Father. That there is a God the Father. And are you in this God? Do you know the God Father? That He is a Father God. That He is a Father God. That He is your Father God. He is the Creator. And He is your Father, the Father God. Do you know the Father God today? Are you in the Father God today? Do you know the Father God today? Where there is forgiveness, where there is peace, where there is mercy, where there is grace, where there is love. Do you know the Father God today? He is your Father God. A Father God that will show you His love. A Father God that will show you His mercy. A Father God that wants a relationship with you and you to have a relationship with your Father God. Do you know the Father God today in your life? There is a Father God. A God to cry to, a God to pray to, a God whom you can know today. He is the only God. There is no other God. He says, Father God, here. Not the Buddhist God, not the Mohammedan God, not the Israelite, not the Mormon God, or the Jehovah's Witness God. He says here, which is in God the Father. God the Father, the biblical God. The God of the Old Testament and the God of the New Testament. Do you know this God? Are you right with this God? Do you know God the Father in your life? Which is in God the Father and in the Lord Jesus Christ. To be in God the Father, you have to be in the Lord Jesus Christ. If you want to know God the Father, you have to be in the Lord Jesus Christ. You cannot know God through religion.
God bless you, bro.
You cannot know God through false prophets. You cannot know God through Muhammad. Muhammad cannot help you. Muhammad cannot save you. Buddha cannot help you. Buddha cannot save you. Joseph Smith cannot save you. Muhammad cannot save you, Joseph Smith cannot save you, Buddha cannot save you, the devil cannot save you. The only person that can save you is Jesus Christ. The only person that can save you is Jesus Christ. Only He can save you. Only He died for your sin. Jesus said, many will come in My name. Many will come in My name. Many will come as false prophets, setting themselves up as false prophets. And there are many false prophets today. Islam is false prophets. Joseph Smith is a false prophet. The Jehovah's Witness are a false prophet. Political correctness is false prophet. The prophet of all time, Isaiah said, unto us a child is born. His name shall be Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Prince of Peace. Only he, the Messiah, can save you. Only he, the Messiah, can save you. You're being brainwashed by this age. You're being brainwashed by the television. You're being brainwashed by the media. You're being brainwashed by all the media pumping into your mind things that are not of God. And you're brainwashed. But Jesus wants to set you free. Set you free from the brainwashing that you're getting today on the media. The BBC should be shut down and never allowed to broadcast again. What you need is Jesus Christ. That's what you need today. You need Jesus Christ. Christ is the only one that can save you. Says God the Father and the Lord Jesus Christ, grace be unto you and peace from God the Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Grace and peace. We need peace in this world. We've got 20,000 jihadists in this country. And here in the Bible it says grace and peace to you. Grace and peace to you. There's peace in this book. The peace of God. Are you a person of peace? Or are you full of hatred? Are you a person of peace? Or are you like a Rottweiler at home in your kitchen? Snapping at your girlfriend, snapping at your boyfriend. There's no peace in your home. Or are you like a Rottweiler at home? Snapping at your wife, snapping at your husband. Peace. Let peace reign in your life. Let peace reign in your home. But it comes through grace. Grace means you forgive. You say, Jay, I'm not going to forgive him. He's doing my head in. You forgive. Jay, I'm not going to forgive her. She's doing my head in. You forgive. Forgive because Christ forgave you. He forgave you at the cross. He shed his blood for you at the cross. He died for you at the cross. So you shouldn't have any bitterness in your heart. You shouldn't be bitter, because if you're bitter, you're bound in chains. If you're bitter against anybody, you're bound in chains. You need to be set free. And set that person free. You say, Jay, you don't know how much they hurt me. You don't know how much they've hurt me. Forgive. Jesus forgave. They hurt him. They battered him on a cross. They nailed him to a cross, but he forgave. Forgiveness. Forgiveness is at the heart of the gospel. Jesus forgave you. He forgave you on that cross. He shed his blood and forgave you. But you have to believe in him to receive the forgiveness. You've got to receive that forgiveness. You've got to look for him forgiveness. You've got to look to him for mercy. You've got to look to him. You've got to turn to him and cry out to him and say, Lord, forgive me. Forgive my bitter heart. I'm sorry for being bitter. I'm sorry for being bitter. Forgive my bitterness. Are you bitter tonight? Are you bitter today? Are you bitter against someone in the past who hurt you? Are you full of bitterness today? You shouldn't be bitter. You say, Jay, I'm justified in being bitter. No, you're not. He forgave you at the cross. He forgave you at the cross. Now you forgive them. Go be bitter in your life. Bitterness is like a chain around your neck. It will destroy your life if you're full of bitterness. Set yourself free and set your family free and forgive. Don't be bitter. Bitterness will destroy you. It's like a cancer if you're not forgiving. It's like a cancer that will eat away at you if you're not forgiving. If you can't forgive, it's like a cancer in you. And it will gnaw at you, and it will eat you alive, and it will tear you apart. You must forgive. For he forgave you. He forgave you at the cross. He died for you at the cross. He shed his blood for you at the cross. So why can't you forgive? If he died for you, why can't you forgive? He shed his blood and died on that cross and gave his life for you. He says, forgive 70 times 7. Forgiveness will clean you, it will refresh you, it will set you free. But you've got to start by receiving forgiveness in your life. You've got to start by receiving the grace of God in your life. The mercy of God. There is grace for you today. You might walk with your head down and you say, oh, I failed as a husband. There's grace for you, my friend. You might say, Jay, I failed as a wife. There's grace for you. Grace abundant. Grace magnificent. Grace wonderful. Grace beautiful. Grace glorious. The grace of God. The grace of God for you. To forgive you. Say, Jay, I've been on drugs for years. I've been taking my crack cocaine for years. I've been on crack for years. Oh, there's forgiveness for you. Great forgiveness. Great forgiveness for you. Great mercy for you. Great love for you. Great kindness for you. He wants to forgive you today. Wash you today. Clean you today with his love. Oh, his grace is wonderful. Say, Jay, I've been a prostitute for quite a few months now. And I've earned quite a few quid as a prostitute. There's grace for you, my friend. Grace abundant, grace wonderful, grace glorious, grace for you. Oh, wonderful grace. Amazing grace. Grace undeserving, grace fulfilling, grace refreshing, grace will retire for you. Say, Jay, I've been a pimp. And I've been pimping them girls, bro. I've been pimping them. Well, my friend, there's grace for you too, Mr. Pimp. You can be forgiven if you repent, Mr. Pimp. You can come to Jesus, Mr. Pimp, and repent of your pimping, and know that you can be forgiven, Mr. Pimp. You can be forgiven, Mr. Pimp, if only you would come and know the grace of God, and the wonderful grace that he has for you. Oh, how he loved you. How he died for you, Mr. Pimp. How he shed his blood for you. How he gave his life for you, Mr. Pimp. Put down your pimping, Mr. Pimp, and come to the Lord and know his love in your life. Know that wonderful love where you can be restored and you can be forgiven today. So, Mr. Pimp, put down your pimping and come to Jesus today. Hey, drug dealer, you're making a lot of money, are you? Guess what, drug dealer? There's grace for you too, drug dealer. Hey, drug dealer, Jesus died for you, drug dealer. How much money are you making today, drug dealer? How many lives are you going to destroy today, drug dealer? You think you're clever, drug dealer? You think you're smart, drug dealer? But look at the lives you keep destroying this Christmas, drug dealer. Look at that girl on the street you've destroyed selling that crack cocaine. Drug dealer, wake up. There's grace for you. Forgiveness for you, mercy for you, love for you. Love for you, drug dealer. Drug dealer, there's love for you, yes. You say, no, there's no love for me, Jay. I battered people as a drug dealer. I smashed people's nose in as a drug dealer. Hey, my friend, no swearing like against the rapper, bro. No swearing like against the rapper, sir. Mercy for you, drug dealer. Grace for you, drug dealer. Oh, drug dealer, come. Come and know his love. Come and know his grace. Come and know his joy. Come and know his peace. Drug dealer, come. Come out of that drug dealing, drug dealer, and come to Jesus. Put down them drugs, drug dealer. Hey, how much did you make today? 20 quid, 30 quid, 40 quid? But how many lives have you ruined, drug dealer? Come. Come and know his love. There's grace for you, drug dealer. There's grace for you and love for you at the cross. If only you would come and believe on him and trust him as your Lord and Savior. If only you would put your faith in him and have faith in him, drug dealer. Hey, wife beater! Hey, wife beater! Beat your wife up last week, did you? Hey, wife beater! Guess what, wife beater? There's even grace for you, Mr. Wife beater! You beat your wife last week, Mr. Wife beater! You can be forgiven today. There's love for you, Mr. Wife beater. If you beat your wife, you can be forgiven today.
I'm not talking to you, bro.
If you beat your wife up, you can know forgiveness today. If you repent, turn away from that ugly violence in your house, Mr. Wife beater. Repent of your wife beating. Remember that Christ died for you. Remember that Christ shed his blood. Remember that he gave his life for your wife beater. And then you can be saved, wife beater. He shed his blood for your wife beater. Gave his life for your wife beater. So come, wife beater, and stop beating your wife. Stop snapping at your wife and come to Jesus. Put down the violence and come to his love. Come to his love and know his love in your life. Know the mercy of God, the love of God. Know the love of God in your life. Know the joy of the Lord in your life. Know the grace of God in your life. Know that love, that joy that he gave his life for you. Shedding his blood for you. It says, and then God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ, we are saved in Jesus. But in your house, it's like a Jeremy Kyle show in your house. You keep snapping and snapping and snapping at your boyfriend and your girlfriend. You're snapping all the time in your house, and it's like you're a Rottweiler shouting at your girlfriend, shouting at your boyfriend. You shout at your boyfriend or you shout at your girlfriend in your home, and it's like a Jeremy Kyle show. It's like a Jeremy Kyle show. You can be saved and forgiven today. You can be saved and forgiven today. God forgives you if you come to the cross. And he can clean you if you come to the cross. And he can wash you clean today if you come to the cross. And know his love and joy and peace today. If you only come to the cross. It's come to the cross. Don't be proud. If you're proud, I'll see you in hell, folks. If you're proud and arrogant and reject the gospel, you're going to go to hell. And you don't want to go to hell. You don't want to go to hell, my friend. You do not want to go to hell. You don't want to go to hell for a day. You need to believe in Jesus and know that he loved you. Know that he shed his blood for you. Know that he gave his life for you. So come, find his grace, find his love, find his mercy. Please, find his love.